is the development of the mid-latitude cyclone. Now, you must know that when we have the mid-latitude cyclone, we have four stages of development. The initial stage, the development stage, the mature stage, as well as the occlusion stage. These are the four stages, and you must be in a position to describe each of these stages. A very popular question is that they will give you a synoptic weather map, and they will ask you in which stage each of these mid-latitude cyclones are. Now, in this case, it's quite easy, because of course, this would be our development stage that we've got here. Can you see them? This one will be our mature stage, and of course, that one will be the occlusion stage. You must be able to put the stages in the correct order, and you must be able to describe the characteristics of each of these stages. Very, very, very important that you must be in a position to do that. Now, when you have a few cyclones in the same area, more or less in the same area, it's called a family of cyclones. Of course, you have a look at family. Three of them, each one different ages, just as your family there at home. So this is called the family of your cyclones. Okay, now this question appeared in last year's examination, and students had lots of problems answering this question. It's a very important question. It's a paragraph type question. Now, Matrix, let me just speak very quickly about paragraph type questions. Please, people, you know, the paragraph type questions are sometimes very, very poorly answered in the exams. The reasons, therefore, is that you don't practice to write your paragraph type questions. So during the course of this year, when we visit you, have a look at the way in which we answer the paragraph type questions, and please look at them, study them, and try to write them. But first, and most importantly, you must know how to read them. So let's have a look at this one. This one appeared in last year's exam, and as you see, it's basically a direct question. Write a paragraph in which you explain the development of a cold front occlusion. Now, if they ask you to write a paragraph in which you explain the development of a cold front occlusion, then it means that you must know that the occlusion follows the mature stage. So in other words, what they are actually asking you is to describe this stage as it moves over towards that stage. You must explain the development of the occlusion. Now, here we've got the mature stage. Now, this is what your answer should have looked like. In the mature stage, the air behind the cold front is cold. We've heard about that, am I right? Here we've got the cold air, here we've got the warm air, and the cold air is moving towards the warm air. Now, what's very important is that you must know that the cold air is moving much faster than the warm air. And as it moves much faster, it drags this cold front along, and what happens is this cold front starts to catch, it moves closer and closer and closer towards the warm front, and eventually it catches up with this warm front, right? And then this is the stage that you get here. You see the cold front started to move towards the warm front. It caught up with the warm front. And what happens then is that the cold front, the cold air of the cold front undercuts the warm front. And have a look at this diagram that we've got here. Here we've got the cold air. You see it undercut the warm air. And what happened is, look at the last fact there. The warm sector is lift off the surface. Here's the warm air. And if you can remember the first diagram that we had, the warm air was on this side and the cold air was that on this side. But see what the cold air did. It moved towards the warm air, it catched up with the warm front, and what happened was, as the cold front undercut the warm front, it lifted up the air, and now you get all the warm air you get there in the atmosphere, upper atmosphere. What I want to like to show you is, have a look at this diagram. They can also ask you to draw a diagram of a cold front occlusion. And please, Matrix, now early in the year, when you get the diagrams, please practice your diagrams. In fact, if you get a diagram, especially diagrams that are very simple, easy to draw, like these ones, for instance, whether it's a cold front, a warm front, or occlusion, these type of diagrams, you must be in a position to draw the stuff. In last year's and previous year's examination, too many candidates lost too many marks because they were not in the position to draw simple diagrams. So please remember, geography is about diagrams, right? You can explain things by means of diagrams. Make sure that you can draw your diagrams.